Welcome back. Alpha Technology specializes in artificial intelligence in various industries. And this is one of the fastest growing, most interesting industries that is going on right now. So with me, the CEO and founder of Alpha Technologies, Harry Virk, and also Simon Elmoudni, the chief information officer for the company. So I guess let's just start with telling me about Alpha Technologies, how long you've been around, what are you trying to accomplish?
Sure. So we've been around since last 20 plus years.
Wow, okay. That's a long time for a tech company. Yeah.
It goes back in 1997.
Okay.
And initially we used to do a lot of staff augmentation, but then we added our services, which is onshore, offsite managed services. And then we added a lot of innovations area, which Simon is handling it. We talk a lot about AI, natural language processing, machine learning, and blockchain. So that's our, we have three lines of business. First is obviously the innovation area, and then the onshore offsite managed services. And then we also do on the side staff augmentation.
Simon, explain like the innovation part of this, because AI is growing rapidly.
Yes. I mean,
how does that play into the company?
Sure. I think first, our innovation portfolio is actually made out of four major technologies, right? Data science, RPA, which is robotic process automation. And we have blockchain, like private blockchain, as well as public blockchain. Then the IoT space. Going back to your question on the data science space, we have three major focuses. The first one is in image processing, statistical learning, and natural language processing. The last one is more complex because of the nature of the human language itself.
So walk me through a company would buy your services, contractor services, and they would use that for their own internal artificial intelligence needs, data analysis. Is that how it works?
Our staff basically works on developing a customized applications using data science.
So, and there are other AI companies out there. What makes you different than them?
Right. I think what makes it really different is that we tailor and customize solutions specifically for our client given a specific business problem.
Okay.
In other words, we don't create this big software solution and try to fit client's problem into our product. We actually do it the other way around. We sit down with the client, we understand what the problem is, and then we go back and then we put this strategy and how to solve the problem. Then we go back and forth with the client to create something tailored, customized for them. And the whole process takes not even 6 months.
I'll add that a little bit more, what Simon said. Thank you, Simon. What we do as Simon's team, they sit down with the client and they get the business requirements as Simon explained. What do? We invest our own money to do the POC, proof of concept, that our team works on it, do the mock-ups, do the proof of concept, and then Simon's team go back to the client. This is what exactly you're looking for, right? We are not, you know, if anything add or change, let us know. So that POC, client is not spending a single dime on it.
Oh.
We are putting our own money. So we have our skin in the game. Now we go back with the POC, if client likes it, then we turn into a project. So that's a major differentiator. Most companies, they say, well, we will do the POC for you. We want,
you
have to pay $100,000 or $250,000.
Okay.
We say, you know what, we'll put our money. Because we, you know, the client is really happy about it because he's saying, look, I'm not spending any money, right? It's Alpha's money, Alpha is spending. Right. If I like the product.
Sure that it works before
Exactly.
We show value, right?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. We show value before the client invests any dime.
Well, there's differences too, financial industry versus healthcare.
Absolutely.
In terms of what they're looking for and the data that they need and how they analyze it and all that.
Yes.
So talk to me about the future of AI. Where do you see this going? Will it become something that we're all seeing in every industry?
Absolutely, yes. I think I'll focus on the NLP, natural language processing, because I think that one specifically has reached really some very good results.
Okay. So
we can tell sarcasm, we can tell feeling language, because language is complex, right?
For instance, oh, sure.
For instance, if I come to you and say, let's say a chicken or something, you say, no, I want to have a steak or something, right? But if I go to let's say, a supermarket, and they ask somebody who wants their chicken, which is the same word, he or she's going to say aisle 7 or something, right? Mm-hmm. So which means different things given the context, yeah. Given the tone, how we speak.
That's amazing. I mean, I remember reading once that AI was having trouble detecting like colloquialisms or like,
correct.
Like it's raining cats and dogs. Like, right. You know, they would take that literally, but you're saying there at someday we'll be able to know.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And again, just because of that distributed representations of word now.
So Harry, tell me about Alpha then. Where are you going to kind of position yourself for this rapidly changing industry?
So we are hiring a lot of PhD students from the good universities. And there's a shortage of labor, the shortage of talent.
That's right, in information technology.
Especially in the data science space.
Science, yeah.
And the supply versus demand, is like there's so much demand and there's not much supply. Mm. So we are working closely with some of the PhD students come and work with us.
Well, and I'm hearing too, study math and computers and right, the STEM right. things, because there's going to be a lot of jobs, sounds like, for the
exactly.
foreseeable future.
Yes.
So.
Absolutely.
Okay. Thank you, Simon and Harry, for
sure.
coming in.
Thank you, Jen.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
And thank you as well for joining us. We'll be right back.